Praise the Lord, precious saints. Well, this very evening, I'd like to do a prayer in relation to envy and jealousy. That's right, because envy and jealousy is rottenness to the bones. As we're going to look at these particular spirits and the spirits that hide behind these characteristics, I want to start with the definitions of them individually and each spiritual root. So envy, according to the dictionary, it's coming up with discontented desire or resentment aroused by another's possessions or achievements or advantages. Now, that could also come along the terms of covetousness, which is spoken about in the Ten Commandments. So jealousy, on the other hand, is fearful of losing what one has to another, someone's love or affection, either a husband or wife, relationship, friends, arises from envy. It's an uneasiness that arises, or envy, because of the fear that someone is going to rob something or somebody is going to rob you of love. What happens next is that we become suspicious and suspect things to happen that you have no proof of, and quickly the person moves into vain imaginations. So these events can happen before we even realize what has occurred. And that is why we have to speak the scriptures appropriately. According to 2 Corinthians 10 verses 5 says, it says, it is vitally important to cast down vain imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing into captivity every thought into the obedience of Christ. So in the Hebrews, envy and jealousy have essentially the same meaning. So what the word says about envy and jealousy is, Job 5 verse 2 says, the wrath killeth the foolish man, and envy slayeth the still one. Proverbs 14:30, a sound heart is the life of the flesh, but envy the rottenness of the bones. And Proverbs 27 verse 4, wrath is cruel and anger is outrageous, but who is able to stand before envy, with a question mark? And we know, according to Romans 1, some of the fruits are that when we forget God and when we do not worship the Creator but worship the creation, what are some of those bad things that start to happen? We can see that people will be filled with unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, goes on and goes on. So we can see that these aspects come about. And then what did Jesus say? According to Mark 7 verse 20 onwards, says, and he said, that which come out of the man, that is what defileth the man. For from within, or out of the heart of a man, proceeds what? Evil thoughts, adulteries, fornications, murderers, thefts, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lavishness, and an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these evil things come from within and they defile a man. And we also see in Galatians 5, the works of the flesh, they go on to say, what? Watch out for seductions, heresies, envyings, murderers, drunkenness, rivalries. So we can see that the spiritual root issue behind envy and jealousy is essentially fear, because fear of displacement due to the deception of covetousness. Covetousness, according to the Webster Dictionary, to desire that which is another's, or to wish for excessively, crave or envy, is rottenness to the bones, and jealousy is rottenness to the bones. Hallelujah. So an open door comes into our lives for these demons to come in when we look at others for acceptance that only God can give us. Therefore, we begin to suspect someone or something is trying to move us out of God, the place, out of placing God has placed with us. So you may have never been displaced, although the spirit is still operating in your life. This could be due to a generational curse operating. So we must be suspect of these things. So some people are displaced, like we see refugees have been displaced because of war but within their particular countries. But then we see other people have never been displaced, though there is a displacing spirit that seems to follow them all of their life. So the open door sets the stage for the person to begin going to the lesser rather than the greater, which is what? Idolatry. Proverbs says this, according to Proverbs 13:20, that whoever walks with the wise will be wiser, but a companion of fools will suffer harm. So as we look at this, we want to introduce envy, obviously, within those two ways. Envy's accomplishments. You know, and there are four people in the world before envy even shows up. And there are three people in the world, Adam and Eve, who have sons named Cain and Abel. And Abel is a shepherd and Cain is a farmer. But Abel brings an offering to God and God loves and accepts because it comes from a heart that genuinely loves the Lord and wants to please the Lord. But Cain brings an offering to God that God hates and rejects because it comes from a heart that does not love God, that doesn't want to please God. And the Bible says the Lord had regarded for Abel and his offering, but for Cain and his offering, he had no regard. So Cain was very angry and his countenance fell and his face fell. So God accepts Abel's offering and he rejects Cain. And that is when envy shows up. Envy convinces Cain that somehow God's rejection of his offering is directly tied to his acceptance of Abel's offering, as if God can only accept one of them. Envy leads to hatred, and hatred leads to murder, and soon Cain had killed Abel. So envy celebrates a victory. So a few generations later, envy shows up in a marriage, and that is between Jacob, who has married two women, but only one of them is able to have children. So Leah, the unwanted and unbeautiful wife, gives birth to baby after baby. And then envy shows up and convinces Rachel, the beloved and beautiful wife, that Leah's children somehow implicate her, and Rachel would rather die than rejoice at her sister's blessing. With every fight, with every tear, with every act of adultery, envy rejoices. So envy is not done yet. Eventually, Rachel does have children and she names him Joseph, and he is the favored son of the father. But Joseph's brothers hate him for this, and they are envious of his position and rally that envious of the fact is that they're going to attack him and sell him as a slave. So envy celebrates another victory. So, and then it goes on, envy shows up all throughout the Bible and it makes its appearance after appearance, and it always brings a death and misery and destruction with them, and even shows up at the end of the life of Jesus and helps even murder the Son of God. Let's look at that. So Jesus has been brought before Pilate and the crowds are crying out for this innocent man to be slaughtered, to be put to death in the cruelest possible manner. And even Pilate himself can see, and according to Matthew 27 verse 18, it says, it was out of envy that they had delivered him up. So envy has a long and ugly history of dissatisfaction and fighting and death, that which makes, you know, us start to wonder why and how can friendships be maintained with that spirit of envy, jealousy, or covetousness. Now, there is a spirit called a Minerva spirit. Now, this Minerva spirit is a Roman goddess spirit who was a mythical demonic goddess of wisdom and war. But this particular spirit seems to harbor these things. It comes in, and it's very well known within California and many of the Latino countries. It sows discord, resentment, hatred, and ultimate death. it binds and casts. You've got to really deliver this thing. Now, it's interesting, even on the California seal within that state, is they have this maneuver on their crest. So also you can see that there's a shield of the head of Medusa on that particular seal as well. So whatever that seal touches, every marriage, every license, jealousy, envy, and covetousness is a problem that comes upon and has a legal right on many people that don't understand the spiritual implication. So let's look at this jealousy strong man, because the lesser spirits underneath it could be anger, rage, bitterness, resentment, hatred, strife, division, dissension, confusion, mockery, cruelty, scoffing, murder, revenge, contention, extreme competition, strangulation, suffocation, choking spirit, confusion. So, you know, when we see this, we can probably say that most people have some or have experienced some form of envy or jealousy. So, and yes, unless you've done warfare against this and do it often, you most likely have this spirit controlling and influencing you in some sense of the word. It most likely came in as a child through sibling rivalry, where jealousy took over, through you being jealousy or over partial treatment being given to one sister or brother, or maybe through a schoolmate. It comes in at an early age. Then as you feed it through the years, it grows so that when you're an adult, it's completely out of control. And you may just think that you have an anger management problem. Not so. A spirit of anger has come in, yes, but a spirit of envy and jealousy was there first. So many, and how many of your relatives or friends that you would come across may exhibit this at times. So this is the root of most family problems. Trouble at church and in the workplace, start coming against it, because that's the problem. It's envy and jealousy. It brings in contention and strife, division and dissension, and thrills the devil to no end, because of he can bring strife into any home or workplace that he has allowed or has the opportunity to come in through these devices. So how many times have you wanted to murder someone, or even thought of that, or anger? Even the Bible says that if you're angry at the person, it's the same as murder within the heart. So not that you'd really go and do it, but have you ever said that you wanted revenge, or vengeance is mine, saith the Lord? That is what the word of God says. So you may have three of these or lesser demons, but no one is exempt from these emotions, but it's a matter of how we combat it. So this Maneva spirit is connected to this one, alive and well. It sows discord, resentment, hatred, and ultimate death. Bind and cast it out in Jesus' mighty name. Come against it. Come against it as often as you can. So Isaiah 14 verses 12 says, and we see the first demonic spirit in the Bible is spoken about is Luther, and he's exalted himself, because it says, "Oh, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning, how thou cut down to the ground, and how thou weakens the nations, for thou have said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven, and I will exalt my throne above the stars, and I will sit in the mount of congregation," and so forth and so forth. So Lucifer was driven and motivated to sin against the Most High God, because he was jealous of the honor God received. He wanted to be like God. The enemy hates it when we worship God and wants to stop us worshiping in any way possible. So jealousy is operating in your life if you are unable to give others honor, or if when someone else receives recognition or honor, you are thinking about yourself, what about me? Why did they get that and I didn't? You don't know the whole circumstance or the sacrifices that that person has walked in before you. And by where they are in the Lord or in life, you just immediately move into judgment, comparison, and lack of appreciation for another person. So comparing yourself with someone else, you're never satisfied. It keeps persons from being who they are. It steals peace. It thinks God will not provide. The reality of who I am in creation, I am unique, no accident. God did not make any mistakes. Opposite of envy and jealousy comes according to Isaiah 53. We see when Jesus came. He came and he didn't even utter a word to the cross. So we must get our eyes off others and onto God, and do not entertain thoughts of comparison with others. You are the daughter of the king. You are the son of the king, and he has plans according for each of us, according to Jeremiah 29:11. The plans he has for you, they are good plans and not of evil. Godliness with contentment is a great gain, according to 1 Timothy 6:6. So seek godliness as your foundation. Envy and jealousy will not allow contentment. It steals self-esteem, always stirring up the pot by comparing self with others to bring division. So let's not do that. So we can see that it's also rooted in idolatry. It's also rooted in the fear of man. The Bible says they're unable to rejoice with those that rejoice, according to Romans 12:15. So let's not allow that to come into our hearts, and let's ask God to remove it from our lives for anything. See, jealousy will bind you from operating in your anointing and gifting, and it will keep you from being used, released, or having ministry opportunities. So the kingdom of God suffers violence, but the violent take it back by force. Meaning, we believers most suffer even to death by the violent, holy one, take it back with the enemy has stolen from them by force. So you've got to take these things back. The enemy hates for us to be a friend of God. What can save us from the spirit of jealousy? What can you do to protect yourself from envy and jealousy? Learn to thank others. Learn to lift others up. Learn to praise others when other people are being exalted. Learn to fast. Learn to pray. And God will help you and God will promote you, because God always exalts the humble, but he always humbles the exalted. So according to Psalm 84, verses 11, it says, "The Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly." Let's allow the Lord to truly be a shield and protector for us. According to Proverbs 27, verse 4, "Anger is cruel and fury is overwhelming, but who can stand before jealousy?" Father, your word describes jealousy as more than cruelty, an overwhelming fury. Father, remove from me any of the components of jealousy or the covetousness, hatred, fear, and insecurity that fuel it. Lord, I renounce all jealousy and envy and fear and insecurity, and pray that you will cover any of the root causes in my past that would keep me walking in unholy jealousy towards others. I want to be holy as you are holy, Father. Remove from us the heart of all cruelty and any murderous attitudes that accompany jealousy within our lives. Psalm 78 verse 58 says, "They angered him with their high places. They aroused his jealousy with their idols." Psalm 79 verses 5, "How long, O Lord, will you be angry forever? How long will you be jealousy burn like fire?" Father, even as you are jealous over us, Father, to be jealous over us time and time with you. Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus. It is only in your presence that we can be healed from the ungodly kind of jealousy that eats away at our spiritual attitudes. Fill us with your love and kindness, and that we may love others the way that you love us, Lord, and the way that you love them. Proverbs 6, verse 34 says these words, "For jealousy arouses a husband's fury, and he will show no mercy when he takes revenge. He will not accept any compensation. He will refuse the bribe, however great it is. And according to Zephaniah verses 1:18, neither their silver nor their gold will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath, in the fire of his jealousy, for the whole world will be consumed, for he will make a sudden end of all who live on the earth. Thank you, Father, that you are jealous like this over each and every one of your children. Help us to remember that you love us so much, Lord, that we do not need to defend ourselves, for you are our defender. Help us to remember how your love is on fire for us, and help us to love you with the same love, Father. Lord, we pray and we thank you. And according to Song of Solomon's verses 8, chapter 8, verse 6, it says, place me like a seal over your heart, like a seal on your arm, for love is as strong as death, its jealousy unyielding as the grave. It burns like blazing fire, like a mighty flame. Many waters cannot quench love, rivers cannot wash it away. If one were to give all the wealth of his house for love, it would be utterly scorned. So jealousy is unyielding, it says, Lord, but we want to be completely yielded to you. Please give us the grace to surrender completely our whole life to you. Help us to surrender our time, our thoughts, our will, our heart to your ways and to your will. Bind our minds, Lord, that our minds may be bound in yours, and that our will be your will, in Jesus' mighty name. Ezekiel 35 verse 11 says, therefore, as surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord, I will treat you in accordance with the anger and jealousy you have shown in your hatred of them, and I will make myself among them when I judge you. Oh Lord, forgive us for the times that we have been jealous or envious of others. Lord, forgive us for being covetous of any person. Forgive us for trying to obtain what others have, for selfish ambition and trying to make ourselves prominent out of our own insecurities and need for attention. Help us to submit to your will completely in all areas of our life, and change our heart, Lord, to reflect your heart. And according to Acts 5 verse 17, then the high priest and all his associates who were members of the party of the Sadducees were filled with jealousy. They arrested the apostles and put them into the public jail. And according to Acts 13 verse 45, when the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy and talked abusively against Paul and what he was saying. Father, jealousy nailed your son to the cross and tortured your son for all my sins, because while we were yet sinners, you came to die for us. Free us, Father, from all jealousy, including any generational curses of jealousy, envy, or covetousness within our family line. Forgive our family for setting ungodly example of how to cope or deal with life's problems. Help us to change and be more like you. Help us to not compare ourselves with others and what they have, but help us to be content with the gifts that you have given to us and the life that you have made for us. Help us to anticipate and appreciate what we have and all that you have done for us. Fill us with your thankfulness. Indeed, instead of jealousy and envy of others, help us to rejoice on those and those who you rejoice with. And Romans 13 verse 12 says, let us behave decently as in the daytime, not in orgies and drunkenness, not in sexual immorality and debauchery, not in dissension and jealousy. Rather, clothe yourself with the Lord Jesus Christ and do not think of how to gratify the desires of the sinful nature. Father, give us the grace to overcome any immoral fleshly activity in our life that would fuel dissension and jealousy. Remove any pride that would cause us to think of ourselves more deserving or better than others. Help us to put on the Lord Jesus by coming into your presence daily and worshiping you and communicating with you in prayer and studying your word, that our mind may be renewed. We thank you. 1 Corinthians 3, chapter 3, verse 3 says, you are still worldly. For since there is jealousy and quarreling among you, are you not worldly? Are you not acting like mere men? And 2 Corinthians 12:20 says, For I am afraid that when I come, I may not find you as I want you to be, and you may not find me as you want me to be. I fear that there may be quarreling, jealousy, outbursts of anger, faction, slander, gossip, arrogance, and disorder. And we know in Galatians 5, there are the works of the flesh, hatred, contentions, jealousy, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambition, dissensions, heresies, envies, murderers, drunkenness, rivalries, and the like. I tell you beforehand, just as I told you in the past, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. Father, uproot in us any of the works of the flesh that would war against your holiness within us and affect our sanctification process through the Holy Spirit. Bring to us the spirit of burning and burn off all the flesh that would yield to jealousy and envy and cruelty and hatred. Father, do not allow your turtle dove to be turned over to the wild beasts of the earth. Rescue us from all darkness. Fill us with more of your love, peace, kindness, and patience, and overwhelming for us of your love, and that we would not think or act in worldly ways. Give us the grace, Lord, to deny our flesh and to walk in the light as you are in the light. According to Exodus 20, verse 4, you shall not make for yourself any carved image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above or in the heaven below, or in the water under the earth, nor in down deep below, or serve them. For I am the Lord your God, and I am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and to the fourth generation of those that hate me. Exodus 34, verse 13. For you shall worship no other God, for the Lord, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. Let you make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land, that they play the harlot with their gods and make sacrifice for their gods, and one of them invites you, and you eat of his sacrifice. Father, it seems there is an alignment of jealousy with idolatry. So we ask you to remove any idolatry to self or things within our lives. And we ask you, Lord, that you would not yield, we would not yield to covetousness or envy. We renounce all idolatry within us and in the generations before us. And we ask for you to forgive for any ancestral idolatry, and we pray that you would destroy any generational curses upon our lives. We renounce, Lord, we renounce agreement with any of the lies and jealousies and demonstrated within our family growing up and as an adult. We ask you to speak truth to us. Then we pray, when we were tempted to jealousy or envy to others, we pray that you will keep us from harming others with our own insecurity and petty jealousies. Destroy every lie of the enemy over our minds, Father. And we ask you to walk in wholeness and complete our request of holiness for you, Lord Jesus. We thank you. Deuteronomy 4:23 says, the Lord your God is a consuming fire, a jealous God. Deuteronomy 6:15, for the Lord your God is in the midst of you as a jealous God, lest the anger of the Lord of your God be kindled against you. Lord Father, we come and ask and be the all-consuming fire to us. Consume all the flesh, Lord, that will set us free and be free from all envy and jealousy, that we may only look to you for all of our needs, and that we may only serve you in the obedience of the one that sent us. We pray, Lord, that we'll be more and more like you as a result because of the help of the sanctification process through the Holy Spirit. Conform our minds and thoughts to your thoughts, Lord. Lord, take complete control of us, Holy Spirit, that we will not do our own will, but only your will be done. We see, according to Nahum 1, verse 2, it says, God is jealous and the Lord avenges. The Lord avenges and is furious. The Lord will take vengeance on his adversaries, and he reserves wrath for his enemies. We thank you, Lord Jesus, We thank you that in Job 5:2 it says the wrath kills a foolish man and envy slays a simple man. And Proverbs 3 verse 31, do not envy the oppressor or choose none of the ways, for the perverse person is an abomination to the Lord. Father, help us to be slow to anger or wrath. Remove any pain in our hearts that would lead us to anger. Expose any pain that we are unaware of, Lord, that still needs forgiveness. We only want to be like you. We refuse to give in to anger and envy of others. Remove from us any discontentment, even with the way that we are. Help us to love ourselves. Give us a pleasant personality that we might be an encouragement and a blessing to others, instead of always looking at how or fall short of the mark compared to others or envying them goes. Help us to appreciate who you made us to be. You said godliness with contentment is great gain. So great within us the grace and sufficient to get through, to walk in that contentment. Proverbs 14 verse 30, a calm and undisturbed mind and heart are the life and health of the body, but envy, jealousy and wrath are like rottenness of the bones. Proverbs 23 17, let not your heart envy sinners, but continue in the relevant and worshipful fear of the Lord all the day long. Father, you state that jealousy and envy are like causing rottenness to the bones. It gives us a picture of fruit spoiled on the dash, rotting away to nothing. Father, your Son came to bring us life, and that abundantly. Release us all that has, whatever has caused us to walk in envy and jealousy, that we may have that abundant life. We want freedom, Lord, so that we can be and do all that you have called us to do. Help us never to look at what others are doing, or what their plot or personal plots are, or whatever their plate, and look at them with envy. Give us a heart of forgiveness and thankfulness and gratefulness, and remove the roots of bitterness within our lives. And we ask that you will not give us to envy or jealousy anymore, because we are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, and nothing can snatch out of your hand. So help us to trust you more and let go of any control in our lives, to fully yield to your ways and accept anything that happens. You allow all of our benefits. Fill us with the gratitudes. Lord, Ecclesiastes 9:5, for the living know that they will die, but the dead know nothing, and they have no more reward, for the memory of them is forgotten. Also their love, their hatred, and their envy now are perished. So that is what the word of God says. So Father, when we are tempted by the enemy to envy and jealousy, remind us of the life that is only temporary. This is not our home. Father, in our home, and that we have eternal inheritance that is much greater than anything that is in this life. Remove us from all striving and fill us, Lord, today with your love and your grace, because you said, according to Isaiah 26 verse 11, you said, Lord, when your hand is lifted up, that you shall not see, but they will see and be ashamed of their evil envy of people. Yes, the fire of your enemies shall devour them. Father, we don't want to stand before you and have to explain how we were full of envy for others. Help our unbelief, Father. Open our eyes to the roots of envy within our lives. Release us. Do not allow us to be deceived by the enemy anymore. Help us to die to self, because we want you, Lord, and to love what you love and to see what you see. Lord, we pray you will kiss us with your wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you. Fill us with more of your love, that we would overcome any pride, arrogance, ego, anything within our lives. Lord, we renounce all that and any self-sufficiency that we've had. Our self-sufficiency is in you, Father, and we dedicate our lives to you completely and holistic today in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray today, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Help us, Lord, to love our brothers and sisters Jesus, even as you have loved us. Thank you, Father, that you have rescued us from a life of sin and death. Thank you that you have brought us into light, and you will keep us by the power of your grace. Speak truth to our inner man and help us to love the truth, for you are truth, Lord, and nothing is hidden from you. Create in us a pure heart, O Lord, and renew a steadfast spirit within us. And according to 1 Peter 2:1, it says, so be done with every trace of wickedness, depravity, and all deceit and insecurity, and grudges, envy, jealousy, and slander, and evil speaking of every kind. Like newborn babies, you should crave and pure, unadulterated spiritual milk, and by it you may be nurtured and grow unto complete salvation. Father, remove any pretense over our lives. Open our eyes to see, Lord, us as you see us, Lord. Remove any false images that we have of you, Father. Heal our heart and help us to see ourselves as you want us to see, Lord. Reveal to us any areas of pretense, and Lord, that we can be real and integritous and walk in integrity in every way before you. Come, Holy Spirit, and renew our spirits, Lord, and fill our minds and give your eyes, Lord, give us your eyes that we may see as you see, love as you love, hug as you love, have mercy as you have mercy, have compassion as you have compassion. We thank you, Father, that your love is real and you're filling us daily. Lord, we thank you for the Holy Spirit that fills us with the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Come and send your Holy Spirit from the top of our head to the soles of our feet. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrowpath Ministries, Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom.